everybody, this is Christina, the Amputee OT. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how a prosthetic running leg is made. The process of making a running leg starts with taking a cast of your residual limb so that a prosthetist can create a socket to be used with your running blade. The reason prosthetists don't simply duplicate your current socket is because running legs frequently use a different suspension system than your current socket, and they want to ensure the best fit. Jared is going to be using a suction socket, where previously he used a pinlock.
Don't use alcohol as this lubricant.
Okay.
I'll get you real quick.
The process of fitting a check socket for a running leg is very similar to that of a walking leg, and in fact, two identical sockets will be made, one for Jared's running leg and one to replace his walking leg. That way, the same socket and system are being used both for running and walking.
All right. We can go in here, boy. Just settle in there and I'll have to take a look at it. I want you to feel... Just acclimate to it, because I know you've worn a socket for a little while.
Of course, since I have to make things difficult for everybody, my prosthetist ended up just duplicating my check socket, because it is super hard to get my socket right.
Can you stir these and get the poles off the ground?
Alright, I'm gonna pull my own check socket.
Don't mess up!
Well, if you're gonna mess up on your check socket, not someone else.
That's true.
What I'm gonna do is just grab that side, just gotta let it down. Let it down slowly. Keep it lift. Have a comb here.
Or my nose?
Now.
Here Ryan is making measurements so he knows where to attach the blade to the back of my check socket. Because my running blade is mounted at the back or posteriorly, it's actually pretty difficult to adjust it if you get it not quite right. It's not like you can just turn a screw to adjust the toe in or the toe out. So, Ryan and Zach have come up with an inventive way of using basically a double socket in order to make a test prototype for my running leg. Here, a second check socket is being pulled over my first check socket, and they've attached a knee sleeve since I'll be using suction suspension for my running leg rather than my proximal lock. I'm using suction instead of a proximal lock for a more secure and intimately connected fit. After the plastic hardens, the socket has to be cut off of the mold. And now I have a test running leg. Now the more very astute of you will probably notice that it looks like this socket is a little bit too long for me. Running legs are made a little bit taller because they compress down a lot when you run on them. When you walk on them, you feel like your legs are uneven, but when you're running, it feels like they're the right length. Of course, Zach and Ryan will have to check out the way I run and make any minor adjustments if necessary. And they do that with a combination of watching us run and some methods which may seem a little bit unconventional, like watching us hop up and down.
Pretty good. I don't think you changed anything in the wrong plan. All right, face the wall to the left. You feel like it's shooting you up or kind of forward?
Up.
Okay.
Feel like I'm on a pogo stick.
Okay, everybody. Be sure to check out my channel for the next couple of weeks where I'll be talking more about this running leg. And if you have any questions, you can leave them in the comment section below. You can subscribe if you like. I put out new videos every Wednesday. You can follow me on Facebook. That's facebook.com/amputeeot. You can go to amputeebladerunners.com if you're curious about getting a running leg for yourself. And see you later. Bye!
Thanks.
Go ahead.
All right.